Fast? I've been stuck for a year. Well, I don't know when my 2448 happened. Probably look it up. I have a video of it. I don't think... Demos? I don't know. This part of the enrichment center has been left untouched for the last 20 years. You may see some signs of decay. Don't worry. The enrichment center is designed to withstand centuries without proper maintenance. Find a way to exit the chamber. Welcome back to the present. If you are ever unsure,
yeah, that's probably going to be less than optimal.
The present should always look a bit cleaner than the future.
You need a new PB with your new machine. Actually, your last PB, what is that? Sub 20, right? I think you're in the 18 range now.
This process is absolutely safe. Usually.
Okay.
These next chambers will involve cube and button-based testing with the perks of time travel.
You did get a new PB on the new laptop? Good.
A cube placed in the present will appear in the same position in the future. Moving a cube in the present will automatically update the location. This future version of the cube can be moved. Good. Please continue to the next chamber. Understanding the concept of cause and effect will be vital to solving the upcoming tests.
I remember watching the demo of it.
Everything you do in the present has an impact.
At least if it's the one I'm thinking.
The other way around.
Missed the portal. Come here, cube. Sit down on the button. Excuse me. I really need to figure out a better way to zoom because occasionally
while it is impossible to bring a present cube,
my mouse gets overreactive and when I scroll for the jump, scroll for the zoom works. And to move the zoom to scroll up because, well, I need the middle mouse button for the portal. It's not good.
Remember, if you change the destiny of an object in the present, the future version of that object will be affected as well.
Oof.
If this sounds too complicated, you're in luck. The next chamber will only heavily
run out of mouse pad. Bust my strafe. I discombobulate. Oh, okay. Have a decent cube. Up, please. Okay, nice. All right, save.
So, you solved it. Not in the intended timeline, but you solved it. Congratulations.
All right, what did I do? 20 seconds out of there? All right. Not as much as I hope to get in 5. Better than nothing.
This marvelous device will allow you to place 3 different portals. A portal placed in the present will appear on the same surface in the future. A portal placed in the future will not override its existing location. Good. Thinking in four dimensions means not only knowing where to place your portals, but also when. Please ignore that. The decay of this facility over the past
20
years may have caused the destruction of some portal surfaces. Try to find a way around this. Nicely done. Take note, because time portals exist in exactly the same location in both timelines, they can only be placed on surfaces which are intact in both the present and the future. This next chamber will involve the concept of momentum-based traveling through portals. You go in fast, you come out fast. Simple enough.
That was perfect. I never get first try. I did it. Hooray.
Congratulations.
Yay.
Ahead of you is the Aperture Science Time Portal Activation Force Field. This field will activate and deactivate your ability to shoot time portals. It will not fizzle your portals or destroy cubes. Great. The following chamber will combine all the elements you have learned so far. Good luck solving your first test while shooting three different portals. Well done. Traveling through a time portal will also transfer your current momentum into the other timeline. Nicely done. Now, let's move on to some more advanced challenges.
All right, what did that give? Excellent. 3 more seconds. Let's go.
If you are ever unsure where you placed your portals or where you left a cube in the other timeline, feel free to use the puzzle element indicator switch on your portal device. This will display holographic projections of your portals and cubes in the other timeline. Quickly make your way over these turret redemption platforms. Unfortunately, they did not survive their trip to the future. If at any point you are concerned about your odds of survival, don't be. Remember the test subject teleportation devices at the start of each test section. Should you die at any point during this test, we can simply rearrange the atoms you are made of and put them back together. Good as new.
Whoa.
You were curious? No, we cannot make infinite clones of you because of the stupid rules of quantum mechanics. Only once you die can we take your
okay
and recreate your body for continued
wasn't horrible
testing. These lasers should provide a fun change of pace. Please be aware that some test elements may only be functional in one timeline. Great. By now, you might be wondering how it is possible to hear these automated messages, regardless of which timeline you're in. We implanted a small device directly into your brain. That way, you can hear these messages as if they were the voice of your own conscience. Well, they practically are, considering how much of your cerebral cortex we had to remove to make this work.
Hello, thank you for the follow. Out. Okay. 14 didn't screw me this time.
Things are about to get a little more complicated in the next chamber. But don't lose hope. Think about this. As long as you don't see your own corpse lying in the future, it is safe to assume that you saw the chamber.
Excuse me.
During the last 20 years.
Okay. Can we have the reportal, please? Thank you. Can I have the decal, please? Thank you.
You solved it. Not in the intended timeline, but you solved it. Congratulations.
Okay, what was that? Oh, in your face. Welcome. Wall strafe, the wall you're closest to. You see you holding left when the left wall is miles away and the right is closer. Sudden burst of noise, scared. Yeah. The follow
is the only one stable enough to last longer than a few microseconds.
Okay.
Good. The second half of this testing course is located below you. Unfortunately, no elevator can take you there, so you will have to take the stairs.
But okay. Oh my god, not again, not again. All right. Okay, thank you. Thank you. You. You're doing this the way that I am sure won't mess me up for another 2 minutes of Chamber 17 practice. I had a lot of Chamber 17 practice tonight. I don't want any more Chamber 17 practice. I want to go practice Chamber 18. Okay, wrong button. Everyone, which chamber? 17? I don't like. Used to like 18. 18's been doing me wrong lately. Let's go save, give me a decent. Go save this up. Let's gently.
Outstanding. You are the first test subject to ever make it to this point. In fact, you are the first test subject to ever survive a trip to the future at all.
Okay, let's go. Okay. 25, which route? 17, grabbing the cube. Okay.
These light bridges are great for traversing over deadly ground. As with the lasers, you will often only have one of these at your disposal, so use them wisely.
Yes. Perfect. That's where you gotta put it. You want it to catch. No. That's the wrong spot too. All right, give me this.
Good thinking. With all this talk about time travel, do you ever question the meaning of it all? Do your actions have any consequences? Or are we all just following the deterministic path of the universe? Here's a fun experiment. Listen carefully. The next thing you will do is jump in 3, 2, 1. It appears that the universe is strictly deterministic.
That was a little slow, even for me. There. Save. Crouch. No. Okay, my fingers are on the wrong keys, and I blew that one, but... That was almost a little too high on the portal, but I did come out of it at the right angle. Barely. I think I almost missed that fling. Right. Let me see. Where am I at? A minute? I'm a minute shy.
Good news.
I believe I lost. 17 again. Yeah. 17 again.
Most of them, anyway.
Alright.
Should you find a defective turret in the future, feel free to mark this as a flaw in your test report. Nicely done. And don't worry, you won't encounter any turrets between the test chambers. Except for these ones. At this point, you might rightfully be asking yourself why we put you through all this. This testing track was built as a failsafe. My job is to ensure that testing can continue, no matter the circumstance. You see, this facility is largely controlled by one entity. For some reason.
I think I hit save and I don't think it took. No, it didn't take. Let me go to the autosave.
Nicely done. And don't worry, you won't.
No. Want the quick save.
This testing track was built as a failsafe. My job is to ensure that testing can continue. No matter the circumstance. You see, this facility is largely controlled by
now, save as I already pushed.
This entity seems completely
save again.
20 years from now. That's
nice.
Why the future looks the way it does. We have lost all control, and we need to find a way to restore it.
I'd be so amazing in this game if I could hop on light bridges.
And you might actually fulfill your true purpose.
Wouldn't have to stop and AD strafe all the time. The 5 world record route is fun to do and looks cool when yeah, it is. Hop out of the portal and throw and then just jump and then cube gets grabbed by the funnel and just goes where it needs to be and you catch it and go.
In both timelines. Have fun exploring all your options in the next chamber.
I'm okay if they're like, if I'm not gonna fall off into the muck, I can try, but if they're over muck, they're over goo, I will kill myself in seconds trying to b-hop on a light bridge.
The time bending technology used to create these time portals is only stable in one specific configuration. We cannot choose the
exact point
in time to which the time portals will lead. We can only take a small glimpse of what the facility looks like
20
years from now. What exactly transpired is still unknown, but the data we collected points to a single rogue test subject.
That was a little fumbly.
In the event that something horrific were to happen to this,
not good at light bridges either. Safe than sorry to begin with. On light bridges, I feel like it. Yes, I do the best I can. And one day I dream that I shall be able to b-hop on light bridges, but Not today. Not when I can only do this once a week. Alright. Already. Let's see if I can go sub 27. Get overwhelmed. Take everything one step at a time, and you will soon find the solution. Ooh, you really did it. Definitely sub 27. Capable of nearly anything. Now it's time for your real mission. 2632, probably. We will put you back in stasis until the day of the incident, and you will be the one. I'd be happy in original and bridge intro and die like 50% of the time. There's a decent jump pattern when you're jumping from bridge to bridge, and it's beautiful when you can pull it off. I try little bits of it here and there.